नमो विष्णु पदाय कृष्ण पृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी एते नामिने प्रभुपाद नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे निर्विशेषा श्रीकृष्णा चैतन्या प्रभुनित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैता गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृन्द श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्या हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम राम हरे हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम राम हरे 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 कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम राम हरे 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 कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम राम हरे 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 कृष्ण Thank you. Prabhupada Jaya Prabhupada Prabhupada Srila Prabhupada Gurudeva Jaya Gurudeva Gurudeva Srila Gurudeva హలో భావన హరినామ సంకీర్తనకి
దట్ కర్ణ షుడ్ బి విత్ దుర్యోధన దట్ వాస్ అ గుడ్ డిసిషన్ సో దే విల్ బి సిట్టింగ్ ఆన్ దిస్ సైడ్ అండ్ అగైన్ టీమ్ విల్ బి ఆన్ దిస్ సైడ్ దే సే దట్ నో ఇట్ వాస్ అ మిస్టేక్ కర్ణ కమిటెడ్ అ మిస్టేక్ సీ వి గేవ్ దెం ఫోర్ క్వశ్చన్స్ టు దెం ఫస్ట్ క్వశ్చన్ ఇస్ కమింగ్ Who is experiencing the tug of war in the heart? Say in one word, a material disease that person's heart is experiencing. So they will tell. Who is going to tell the answer? One of you take the mic and tell the answer to this question.
Karna is facing the tug of war in his heart. And the material disease is friendship.
Material disease is friendship, he says. Okay. Friendship. No, actually, you have to name one quality. Here you are presenting it like a tug, but we are not asking for a tug. One quality that so you can call it material friendship. Anybody else, sir?
Material gratitude. I mean, it's more of expressing his gratitude. That's why he is inclined to doing it, because he gave him something, he wants to give back something to him.
Okay,
that is what the whole thing is based upon. It's not friendship is actually a very high word. Friendship is based on love, affection, sharing, selflessness. Okay. But this is not based on that.
So they said friendship, they said gratitude, okay?
Basically, the relationship between Karna and Duryodhana is not friendship. It is like a master-servant relationship. Duryodhana gave him on the spot, and that's why Karna feels gratitude towards him. They are more like friends with benefits. That's all.
Okay. So you all saw the drama. Let us take from audience. Any one of you from the audience can say what was going on in Karna's heart in the last scene. Any of you? Yes? He's saying envy was there for Arjuna. But later on he came to know Arjuna is his brother only. See, you all know Krishna invited him. Actually, he went to drop Krishna in the frontiers of Hastinapur. There is a book called Rashmi Rath by Maitri Sharan Gupta. You know, the whole book is on this only. He's talking about how Karna and discussion with Krishna between the two. Krishna is telling, come to Pandava's side. Duryodhana is telling, be with me. So he faced the tug of war. So what did you feel when you looked at Karna in the last scene? Yes?
Prabhuji, he knew his job. He was on his duty to help Duryodhana. So it's not the gratitude actually, it's his duty to help him. Because actually he had helped him. So it's a way of return.
Okay.
As a duty.
Sense of duty.
Yeah, sense of duty.
Sense of duty was compelling him. Okay. Now at the end of this discussion, I'll tell you, after the whole thing is over, what else was going on in Karna's heart, we'll discuss. He's saying fame, desire for fame, prestige was there. Okay, let us see what was there later. Now question number two, what do you feel about his choice? Was it right or wrong? They say right and they are saying wrong. So here you have given both options. If his choice was right, what would you like to appreciate that they are all going to tell us? If you all say he is wrong, how he could have acted alternatively? So that they will say why he is wrong. So right, wrong, they will argue now. We will hear from them. And then the fourth question is about a practical example that we'll see later. Now let us hear from them. First, give them the mic. Just give them the mic. You have the mic with you? Yeah, start.
Good morning. Karna was from birth humiliated, and despite that, he stood with what he felt was right. Because people get broken down once their beliefs in the society and their beliefs in justice is not reciprocated to them. So he was doing good, but people were not doing good. But Firby, he stood with what he thought was right till the very end. and he kept his word. And like he gave his word to Duryodhana because initially he was good to him. It is like you do one good thing, you might get one good thing back. So at that point of time, that instant, Duryodhana did a right thing of recognizing talent. And rather than just based on what birth, it is like your qualities which define your caste. So he did one good thing for which he was getting the benefits and Karna instantly gave him his word. But once Duryodhana changed his color, Duryodhana is out of his circle of influence. So he cannot control Duryodhana, do like this, do like that. No. Because once he changed his colors, all he could do was renounce, resign from Angrajya. I will not be your king anymore and conspire with you. All I will do is I'll just keep my word because I was bound to. I have no other choice. That is my param dharma. But I will not also go with your wrong things. So I think he has justified all that was good in his good in mankind. And despite being humiliated, despite being cheated or, you know, bad circumstances, he tried to see what is right. He tried to respect the good.
In summary, what he's saying is, Duryodhana saved his face when he was publicly humiliated. Naturally, he felt a sense of duty towards Duryodhana and he kept his word till his last death, and thus Karna is glorious. So my request to all of you, in this August assembly, we only have time till 12. We only have 45 minutes. We have to have everyone getting chance to speak in your group, both sides. So you have to keep your speech very brief and up to the point, and there should be no repetition of any point. So that we'll be able to, I would request the audience to keep your ears very sharp so that you won't miss out anything what they're saying. So I told you the summary of what he said just now. Beautiful point. Thank you. Anybody else want to add any other point? You can say 3-4 points and they will give counter points. Huh? Charts are there. Show it. Yeah. And go ahead. Yeah. Is it on?
And see, actually, during the exhibition of their talents, Duryodhana recognized his talent and gave his word. In the similar manner, suppose when devotees please demigods, then the demigods give a word that, what boon do you want? They'll give a word. And they're given word so that they're supposed to give the boon, whatever the devotees ask, whether they may be drastic or see, they're supposed to be bound to that. You see, the demigods are so high, even they are supposed to bound to the word. There's no wrong in it. Karna bounding to his word given in that sphere at that time. It's
very good. Thank you. Any other point,
sir? I want to add one more point. Lord Shiva given some.
You all can note down. You have to defend,
sir. Lord Shiva had given some promise to Bhasmasura that if he keep anyone his hand on anybody, then will become Bhasma. So even though Bhasmasura
going. You are giving example of what he said.
Yes, sir. I want to
so
give.
That means once you give a word to anyone, you should keep the word. You should not go back.
You should not go back.
Perfect. Thank you. Anybody else? Give the mic.
We can't say Karna is materialistic. Even though Krishna presented entire kingdom for him during Kurukshetra, during peace talk, Karna didn't accept. Karna only followed his friendship. That is his duty. He didn't want material things like kingdom just because he was humiliated and he was given support when he was humiliated. He was performing his duty. That's
a solid point. He's saying that some of you may feel that Duryodhana gave a lollipop and captured Karna on his side, but later on, what did he give a lollipop? A whole chocolate company was gifted by Krishna to Karna, which he denied. He did not accept. So don't think that Karna acted out of emotion. He acted with intelligence. That's what they are saying. Yes. The points are covered.
And I need to say one more point. He's telling about about gratitude. See, one should have a gratitude to anyone. If you don't have a gratitude to a person, human, how will you have a gratitude to the Lord? First, you need to have
you should practice gratitude with human beings.
Yeah.
Then you can practice gratitude with God. Very good. Thank you. Okay, now they are done. Your side. Take the mic. Mic should be on.
They are telling that.
Everybody can see.
Yeah. I'll give them. Yeah. Duryodhana gave him a kingdom. He did the Karna one favor. But right from Karna's birth,
Lord Krishna gave him water to drink, gave him power to fight, he gave him bows and arrows, he gave him intelligence, he gave him wife, children, he gave him everything. So what did Karna do for Krishna? He just denied his words. So that tells all. If Karna was to be so intelligent, in the drama we just saw, Karna was telling Krishna that you are the Supreme Lord, that this. But if Karna knew that, then why didn't he accept the Supreme Lord? That Supreme Lord who has given anything and everything for Krishna right from his birth. So that is a wrong way. Just for one thing, just for a kingdom, Karna was trying to please Duryodhana. What must Karna do for Krishna, who has given infinitely many things for Karna right from his birth?
So they are saying, even the salt that Duryodhana gave Karna was given by Krishna only. You can note the point. You have to define it later. Yeah.
Okay, I just want to present some rebuttals to what they said. They were presenting the concept of integrity. That is, you say something, you do it. It is a very good concept. It is a divine. I mean, it's a good concept that everyone must follow. But when it comes before, when it comes in front of God, okay, when you are going to oppose God, even the highest quality cannot match the degree of harshness which you are showing on God when you are opposing Him. So you may have a factor of integrity, but you need to use your intellect to use your integrity properly. You cannot simply make promises to some ordinary person and for something wrong which isn't exactly correct, and you can't go by it. And the other point which I wanted to make was, they had mentioned that he did his dharma. Dharma is following his duty of they mentioned the word dharma. I want to tell that if this is called dharma, he made a much bigger violation of dharma, which is disgracing and disrobing of women in front of a lot of people. When he can do such a big offense to dharma, you cannot get away with telling that he did a small part of dharma. This is supposed to be a very huge and a big violation to dharma. So he was not a dharmic person. So you cannot argue on the basis of dharma. By this act of his, you can say that he was not dharmic.
So they are saying that one aspect of dharma is to show gratitude and keep one's word, which he did. But the other aspect of dharma is to respect every woman like a mother, which he did not do. So how is it that he shows dharma at one time and he doesn't show dharma another time? So what is the shastra which he is following? Is it Duryodhana Puran? Huh? Like they are asking.
Sir, I want to tell one point.
Sir,
myself.
Okay.
Sir, I want to.
Points they made. Okay.
Okay. I want to tell that he is telling that Karna is not following dharma. Then why Sri Krishna called Karna to join him? If he is not good, then Sri Krishna not asked Duryodhana to come his join and don't do what he didn't tell to Duryodhana. But why he asked Karna to join here and be with Kauravas? Another point I want to mention is, he's telling that by giving a promise to ordinary person, there is no need of keeping that promise. That is not good. If you giving a promise such that you should stand to that promise. Lord, I said an example that Lord Shiva given a promise to ordinary person Bhasmasura. He's in front of Lord, he is a small guy. God didn't think that he said this fellow is what is he and what I can give, I can take my powers back. Who are you?
Reinforcing the previous point on keeping the word. Huh? Any of you want to add anything more?
About your thing of promise, I'll give an example. You're writing an exam. Now you've promised your teacher that if you do not cheat or if you catch anyone who's cheating in the exam, she'll give you 5 marks extra. But your friend is asking you to promise that you will help him get good marks in the exam. So who will you wish to help? Because the teacher will finally give you the marks in the exam, right? If you get my analogy. And second thing about Krishna coming to Karna and asking him to join the Pandavas. Karna is not a bad person. We are not saying that he's a bad person. What he did was wrong. The fact is that he's a good person, but because of material benefits and because of staying with Duryodhana for a very long time, he sucked into, Duryodhana's vortex that, he has to help Duryodhana. And it's not that he's a bad person. Krishna by just by allowing by giving Karna a chance was giving him a chance to reform himself, and Karna denied that flat out.
I just want to add to what he said. Now, basically, you have a lot of you have too many priorities coming in at a time. Like, you made a promise, fine, but there's another priority of going to God will. So you will always, basic intellect says that you will give in to the better priority, even if you have to overrule the other priority. So that is what he should have actually done. When God is coming to request him, he very well knew that, it was very clear that he himself knew that they were not going to win, but he just fought because of his because of the promise which he had made. He should have actually realized that, God will is much more important than that promise which you make to a human. And another point,
very vital points they have brought out. One point they said was Karna was a good person, but he became influenced by bad association. So they made that point. I heard a story of how once when Karna was playing a dice game in the palace with Duryodhana's wife. Her name was Lakshmana. So when he was playing, at that time Duryodhana had gone for hunting in the jungle. In the evening, Duryodhana came back and this game went on and on. And the game went in such a way that Duryodhana's wife was in the losing side. So she just got up and she was about to go away. She told Karna that, I have a lot of things to do, work to do. I'm pushing off now, she said. So seeing that, Karna said, "Oh, Bobby, you cannot go away at a time when you're about to lose." So he caught hold of the end of her sari. And she tried to laugh. She was laughing and moving away. But when he pulled like this, from her sari, all the pearls and ratnas, they got scattered. And they were all jumping and moving in the floor. In those days, if even one pearl falls off from a woman's cloth by a man's pulling, it's equivalent to rape. So at that time, Duryodhana entered. Just then he entered and he saw Karna is pulling his wife's sari and she is laughing and moving away and the pearls are moving like this. So Karna was trembling. He thought there's a possibility of getting misunderstood in the eyes of Duryodhana. But Duryodhana came in and embraced Karna and said, "Karna, I will never misunderstand you. I know that you are just playing a game. You wanted her to stay back and not go away. I understood it and you are my good friend. I trust you and I have no doubts about you." Oh, when he said it, Karna's friendship with Duryodhana became thick, very thick by that. Similarly, there were many instances where Duryodhana invested in Karna. Because he knew that I need a combat for Pandavas. I myself cannot fight with them, but I need some combat equal. And he found a great hero in Karna. And he thought that if I take care of this fellow nicely, I can use him as a tool to attack the Pandavas in future. So as such, Karna was a good person, but he became a guinea pig. Like a scapegoat, we say. Yeah, I can put my leg down. Yeah. Like a scapegoat is used. Sometimes people do that in the court also. They don't want to come in the front. They put somebody who is beaten by the gundas later. Similarly, Karna became a scapegoat in one sense in the hands of Duryodhana, but he got tricked by Duryodhana's friendship. Because Duryodhana actually knew what should be done when, what should be spoken when, in order to win the heart of Karna. Later on, Karna was telling Krishna in Mahabharata, it comes. In this drama, they didn't show it, but it comes as a part of this discussion. As such, I was the one who told Draupadi should be brought in the Sabha and disrobed in the public. Pandava should be driven to the jungle. Why did I speak like this? Simply to give pleasure to my friend, Duryodhana. How many of you experienced in the college, sometimes your teacher has not come to the class. Some 4 or 5 boys are sitting together and talking some rubbish. And you happen to be there. Sometimes even good boys start speaking bad things. How many of you experienced? You seen that? But how they speak bad things, because just like in the Hamlet, he says, "You too, Brutus, then fall Caesar." He says, Similarly, somebody who is a very pure boy with good character, but associating with some kind of certain group of people, he also starts speaking all dirty things. And that's what happened to Karna also. See, Karna is born from Kunti. Naturally, he cannot be bad. But he became bad by the company of Duryodhana. That was one good point they made. I liked it. Then another thing, he made the point that whenever some decision has to be made, it is not necessarily difference between good and bad. It can be difference between good and better. Mahabharata oftentimes teaches about, you know, choice between good and bad. Ramayana teaches a choice between good and better. And Srimad Bhagavatam teaches the best dharma, called Paro Dharma. So what is the choice between good and better? Say, for example, say, sometimes you are unable to say no to one of your friends. So one of your friends tells you, "Arey, chalo yaar, we'll go to beach. We'll spend the evening in the beach. You know, bore lagta room mein. Chalo." You know that next week there is examination. Still, sometimes you go with your friend not to spoil the relationship. You cooperate. Okay, chalo, one evening I will. I have a really limited number of hours for studying. But in the 6 or 7 evenings, one evening I'll give for my friend. So that, you know, he will not feel unhappy. How many of you know that you have made a compromise sometimes to please one of your good friends? Honestly, we all have made compromise, right? Because for us, the relationship is very important. We don't want to break it. We don't say no. So in the same manner, what he made was, sometimes we may not want to compromise on our friendship, but the demand that is made may be too much. Like imagine one of your friends says that, you know, you have to smoke with me. Only then I will think you are my friend. So any of you will compromise on that? You cannot do that. Of course, you may not harshly tell him that, forget it. I don't want to look at your face anymore. You may not say that. You may say that, you know, if you want to smoke, you smoke. I cannot smoke. If you want, I can take a cup of juice. But I cannot smoke. So you do that. I will not stop you doing that. But I cannot do that just for the sake of friendship. Correct? No? Honestly, you have to tell. So he is talking about comparing two things. Your material friendship with Duryodhana on one hand. On the other hand, Lord Krishna is telling something. Say, how weighty is it for one to be given an instruction by Krishna? How weighty is that? Because Karna did know that Krishna is God. He said that also. Krishna, you are God. I know that you know what is best for me. But still, I am unable to give up Duryodhana, he said. So Duryodhana's many long years of friendship attracted him. Both are values. His friendship with Duryodhana is also value. Krishna's order, Krishna's instruction is also value. Now we have to weigh between these two values. So which one is of greater value? We have to see. Is my sense of duty to Duryodhana? Is my friendship with Duryodhana? My gratitude to Duryodhana? These are all on one side of the Raju. On the other side, Krishna himself is asking me, you join Pandava's side, he's ordering me. You know, you should come to Kunti is ordering, that's another thing. But Krishna is ordering is another thing. Kunti is out of emotional affection as a mother, she is calling. Whereas Krishna is calling, is it like that? So how serious it is when Krishna tells somebody, this is good for you and this is what you should do. Correct now. So I would ask this team, why is Krishna's instruction so weighty that Karna should discard the other three criteria, you know, of material friendship, gratitude, sense of duty, which they very nicely, and keeping the word, which they said. He can put aside all these things and follow Krishna's instruction. Why is it so important? Yeah.
Prabhuji, everything comes from him. All the rasas comes from him. So be it friendship, all the rasas comes from him. All the relationship comes from him. So whatever Krishna tells, it will be for the good for his people. So why have we come here? We are the souls which we were thinking of enjoying independently of Krishna. So we have come here. Even then Krishna is helping us to take us back. So whatever Krishna does, it is for our own good. So that is why we have to listen to Krishna's words.
Okay. Just to put it simply,
man can do good and bad as well. There is an equal chance, or probably there's a higher chance for bad or higher chance for good. But God can never do bad. He can only do good.
That is why he's called as God.
So God is all good. God is all compassionate. He is all knowing. So whatever he says is ultimate truth. So we have to follow him. That is his point. Yeah.
Sir, there are two things. First one is duty and second one is dharma. Sometimes if people feel that duty is opposing the dharma, then people have to follow the path of the dharma. As in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna has tells to...
He's saying that there is our duty, sense of duty, you have to follow. But if that sense of duty goes against dharma, then we should give up. For instance, I'll ask you a question. You are a high court judge. On one side, your uncle is standing. On the other side, some other unknown man is standing. As a judge, you have found out that your uncle has done some corruption. And the other fellow is a niraparadhi. So you have to fine your uncle that you have to pay 1 lakh rupees fine. So how many of you here will levy a fine of 1 lakh rupees for your uncle if you are a judge? Aisa hai? Sure. बाहर जाने के बाद आप रिश्तेदार पकड़ेंगे आपको, क्या कर दिया तुमने, मामा को उड़ा दिया, तुम्हारे ही मामा है, तुम्हारे माँ का भाई है, उसको एक लाख फाइन डाल दिया उसके ऊपर, क्या जज हो, तुम्हारे जज होने से हमको परिवार को क्या फायदा हुआ, ऐसे पूछेंगे ना हम। इन स्टिल कॉन्फिडेंट, नो प्रभु जी, आई विल श्योरली लेवी फाइन। हम इन ऑफ यू, हाँ, ऑलमोस्ट हाफ ऑफ देम, ओके, हम इन ऑफ यू विल नॉट फाइन योर अंकल, रेज अ हैंड। Then what about the others? I don't know. They don't know. Actually, you are a judge. You have to give a judgment. You can't run away. You can't say, no, my uncle is standing. I will not give judgment and run away. Can you do that? And that was the situation of Arjuna in the battle also. You know, his relatives are there on the other side and Krishna was telling him to fight. Krishna said, this is dharma side, it's adharma side. You have to fight against them. Correct now? Huh? So, this is a dharma sankat situation. But what they were saying was that, yes, you have a material sense of duty, but if it goes against the dharma, then you have to dharma ko pakad kar chalna chahiye. We can't go by that kind of material sense of duty, they are saying. Yes.
I would like to add with a point from... I would like to add a point, like history has shown that anyone who opposes God and tries to exert his own will over, the world has always been destroyed. So Karna could have taken the example of Vibhishan in the Ramayana, where Vibhishan leaves his own brother because he knows that he has evil intentions and shifts to the side of Lord Rama. That way he was protected and he achieved the purpose of serving God. Actually, this debate is just about, it's like the debate that goes on within every mortal, a tussle between, material benefit and spiritual benefit. Balancing them makes us, the perfect being. Karna was not able to do that. He made the wrong decision. He's not a bad person. He just made the wrong decision.
Point to be emphasized here is that Vibhishana, he left his brother of long years. How many? I don't know how old he was when the war was going on. Of long years, that was a much valuable relationship than a friendship which just started a few years before. He could do that and he went to the side of God because he knew it was right. How difficult would it have been for...
People say Vibhishana was a parivar drohi. Kya apne bhai ko chhod diya usne. Apne maa-baap ko chhod diya, bhai ko chhod diya. Some people say like that. What will you tell them?
And I do have a point. There is no situation where the Pandavas treated Karna as a brother.
They didn't know it actually. Once they knew it, they were ready for it. The person who wants to take the respect has to accept it. If there is no person in the throne, they can't treat anyone. He has to take up the throne. Only then will they respect him.
Now they can speak of you. Ravana, you all have made very solid point. No, let them make anyone.
Prabhuji, it is like Bhagat Singh for us is a national hero. Bhagat Singh to us is a national hero, but for the British, he is a terrorist. Yeah. It depends on the stand from which we look at things. Like, things are, after all, things, just events. It's like the stand which we take.
Krishna is Britisher or Indian?
In that context, an enemy is an enemy.
Yeah.
Right? So, It is like
Krishna,
the stand.
Krishna enemy of Karna.
Enemy of the side for which he is fighting for. So he is of course an enemy.
Actually, in this drama, right? It's a very long drama. They showed a part of it. Karna is telling Krishna, Krishna, you are the Suhridam Sarva Bhutana.
Correct.
Huh? You are the well-wisher of all living beings. So you cannot speak anything wrong. So whatever you are saying must be for the best of all living beings. Krishna is neither British, nor Russian, nor communist or capitalist or anything. Krishna is beyond all that.
But Prabhuji, if you say Krishna manifests himself in everything, so whatever advice Duryodhana gives, why not like all the help that Duryodhana did? Don't you think it is like Krishna manifested through him? Like God cannot manifest himself everywhere. Yeah. So he created people through him. So it is Krishna's word, Krishna's want or will ultimately. And one more thing is Arjuna.
Oh, actually, if one boy was asking Prabhupada, Swamiji, you know, God only created tobacco. That means he wants us to smoke. When he argued, one boy argued with Prabhupada. Prabhupada said, God has created Dathura poison also in the plants. Why did you eat that poison? So then the boy said, no, if I eat that, I'll die. Yes. That means God has created both poison and nectar. You have to discriminate between the two. You pluck a tomato or like a bendy or something and you eat that, but you don't eat the poison because man has to discriminate. Similarly, tobacco is created by God, not for us to eat. We should know it is poisonous, we have to give up. Similarly, can we say whatever Duryodhana speaks is coming out from Krishna only? Duryodhana is a human being. He is one of the kings. Pandavas are other kings. There are two sides. So one has to evaluate which side I should join. One has to think twice. Well, whether I should go according to Krishna's instruction or I should follow my heart following Duryodhana's side. So I appreciate your point on keeping the word and being grateful for Duryodhana's supply of all the eatables and everything. Although it is from Krishna, it's coming through the agency of Duryodhana. You should be grateful for that. So the gratitude part and keeping the word part, not going back, and friendship part, all these things are acceptable. So we have to compare them with Vaidam in relation to that. So what do you all think about Vibhishan, what he did? Do you think Vibhishan was right or wrong? What do you think? Take the mic. Yeah. He is saying Vibhishan was not given respect by Ram. So he left. Ravana. So he left. See, somebody may, I'll tell you one simple example. Somebody smiles at you and offers you respect, embraces you, and then stabs you. Is that person better? Or a person taunts you, scolds you to save you from danger? Who is better?
Prabhuji.
Because the mundane respect is something very superficial, no?
Prabhuji, you can make a decision when there is time. But once, for example, once a baby is born, you cannot say, no, I don't want the kid. So once it is too late, once you've already decided there is war, you cannot go back. So Vibhishana did that. During war, he left. He could have done something before war, then it is acceptable. But assuming once you have a kid and you say, no, I don't want this, it is not fine. So
go back. And
it is like pain is temporary, pride is forever.
Now I'll tell you a simple thing. Whatever he was telling, Shankara Narayana, whatever he said in the beginning, I will put it in black and white more simply. He was making one point which was slightly abstract, which could be explained a little more in lucidity. See, the Shastras say there are many dharmas that we have to do. For example, you have to do one dharma, which is to your mother and father. You have to take care of them. Now, sometimes you think my home is my everything. Children think like that. They clean the home very nicely and take it and throw the dust in the neighbor's compound. And they yell and shout, hey, what is this? Because they think only about their own home. And then they both decide, okay, I will not throw in your home. You don't throw in my home. We both will throw outside the compound. They throw like that. In the same manner, first people think of home. Then they think of their caste people. Then they think of the state people. Then they think of the country people. In this way, our dharma, gradually expands like that. And as we, at a certain time, we even think of people of other countries as human beings. You will not hate Pakistanis. You will not hate Americans. You know that everybody is a human being. Then you start loving animals also. Ultimately, you love God. So When you love God, you know that He is the Father of all creatures. And all creatures are His children. So everybody is our brother and sister. So that's a very broad outlook of God. And then when God means the source of everything, Krishna is the source of everything. And whatever He says is dharma. Like for example, in this room, when it is pitch dark, you lit up a candle. That can give some light to the room. So chota mota dharma are like that. Like, you know, treat everybody like a brother. You know, serve your mother and father. Many dharmas are serve your nation and all that. But when God speaks something, that is like the sun itself shining in the sky. Can somebody take a candle and go and search for the sun? We cannot apply our petty dharmas on God, because whatever God says, dharmam tu sakshat bhagavat pranitam, it says. Whatever God says is ultimate dharma. And as He rightly said, God is all good. Like sometimes a mother may embrace one child. Another child, she may give a slap, because one is doing the studies and another one is not studying. Similarly, for Krishna, He is embracing Pandavas and He is fighting against Duryodhana to defeat Duryodhana, because both are His children. Pandavas, Kauravas, both are His children, ultimately. One child requires a pinch, one child requires an embrace. Correct, no? So, if you are convinced about this truth, that whatever Krishna speaks is the ultimate truth, it is called transcendental morality, you call it. What morality? Transcendental morality. Sometimes, you have to give up your naitikata also. For instance, I'll tell you. Imagine you see a cow running and it enters into some house. And then a butcher is coming running. He's asking you, did you see the cow? What will you say? Ah. If you say, yes, here the cow went, he will bring it out and kill the cow. But if you say, no, I didn't see, then the fellow will run away and then the cow's life will be saved. So the end result of all your behavior is to protect the cow. So you may occasionally tell a lie. Although these are called dharma sankat situations. When we should speak what, but ultimately is it pleasing to God? We should see. So Srila Prabhupada wrote one article called Standard Morality. He wrote, what is standard morality? Standard morality is that morality which pleases the Supreme Lord. He said, Krishna, that's all. Whatever pleases the Supreme Lord is standard morality, he said. For instance, in India, if a woman is roaming alone after 11 o'clock or 12 o'clock at night, people will think she's a characterless woman. In America, Prabhupada says, woman watches people 12 o'clock whole night, they are alone here and there. And nobody talks about their character there. Because different countries have different, Naitika, the rules and regulations are different. Like in our country, if somebody, you meet a guest or somebody, how will you wish the namaste, he said. In some countries, how do you wish the guest? Guest comes, you catch his hand, and then you spit a saliva on his hand. In one country, in certain countries, that's the way you greet a person. You call him and spit. Here in India, you do that, they'll give you a slap. So, different countries have different rules. But ultimately, what we accept is very simple, standard morality. Whatever God says, that is ultimate morality, which makes it very simple. There is the ethical dilemma, which is a big topic in the modern times. Ethical dilemma means, what is right, what is wrong? Bhagavad Gita says, all of you repeat this. Tasmat shastra pramanam te karya akarya vyavasthithau. So he's saying, whenever you want to do anything, you do Shastra Praman. Shastra says, do this, do it. Shastra says, don't do it, don't do it. And where the Shastras are coming from? Dharmam to Sakshat, Bhagavat Pranitam. It says, from Bhagavan only the Shastras come. So now, in case Karna knew that Krishna is speaking the truth, but I am feeling some attachment to Karna, attachment to Duryodhana, my old friend. He has done a lot for me. He is facing tug of war. If any of you were in this situation, what you would have alternatively done, I wanted to ask you. You can also think about it. Of course, these people would say, I would have joined the Pandavas, they would say, you know. But I'm asking these people, if you were in Karna's position, now will you fight on Duryodhana's side? Or what would you have alternatively done?
Sir, Kunti had left the Karna in the river without knowing what will happen to the child at the time of birth only. And after knowing that he is brave enough to fight with Pandavas, then only she told that you are my son. And nowadays, if our mother leaves in at the time of birth and after getting 60 or 70,000 salary, you are my son, come. Then nobody will accept, no sir.
Okay.
Panda, Duryodhana is best friend for him. What he did is very correct, sir, according to my opinion.
Why did she leave? What was the circumstance in which mother left him? See, she invited, actually she got one mantra, you know. She wanted to test that mantra. So she called Suryadev and Suryadev came and gave her a child. But then she remained a virgin also. Huh? She was virgin and she had a child. People will wonder, how is it that you are a virgin and you have a child? Huh? Hey, who is the fellow? Somebody did something with you? People will ask. In the Vedic times, if a woman has a baby, it will become a big issue. She can't show her face to anybody. So she was in a big dilemma. In a very precarious position, she had to put the child in the water, that too very nicely protected in a box. And she hoped that somebody will take the child and take care of it. Either she did that. Okay, that is right. But I am asking you, see, that is the old story. But now, if you are in Karna's position, you have to decide today. What will you decide? Yeah.
As Karna and Duryodhana are good friends, Karna can try to convince Duryodhana.
No. Well, what should you tell Duryodhana? Please, no, don't fight. Give the Pandavas 5 villages. Let them be happy and you rule the whole other part of the world. Like that?
No. As Krishna is eternal, we should hear to him.
Okay.
And we should not go against Krishna.
Okay.
Like that he can say.
Oh, he can tell him like that. Mm. But then Duryodhana has been seeing Krishna for so many years, but he had not developed faith in Krishna, even though Krishna showed that Vishwarupa darshan and all that. Still he hadn't developed. Karna has faith in Krishna, but Duryodhana doesn't have faith. This is the problem. Many of your friends, both of you are thick friends, you have faith in Krishna, but they don't have faith in Krishna. And then your friendship becomes challenging. Correct, no? That was his situation also.
But actually, in this situation, he's provided only two options. He's going to the battlefield. Either is only two options. Either go to the war or go back. There are only two options. Okay?
No, there's a third option also.
Can I know it?
So he can be like Balaram. Balaram walked out.
Neutrally.
Vidura walked out. Many people walked out of the battle. They said, we like people on both the sides and we don't want to join anybody. We'll go on Tirthayatra. They went away. Huh?
Rauji.
So Karna can go for Tirthayatra also?
Yeah, Duryodhana declared war on basis of, trusting Karna is with him. In that situation, actually he has provided two options for him. Please come on my side or stay back with Duryodhana. Yeah, the two options is Duryodhana was helped him a lot, even in the situation where he mistakenly grabbed the queen, even though Duryodhana didn't misunderstood it. Karna should be very grateful. On the other side, though the persons who hated him gratefully and her own mother left him there and her mother came to protect the 5 sons and asked him to protect 5 sons. And their situation. And he didn't have time to think nicely sitting, what would I do and make a sketch. He was on spot situation, way to go to war.
Not on the spot, he had few days. See, this was after the Shanti Dut. This was after the Shanti Dut, this conversation took place. For the war, still there was some time.
But he has declared wars, no, sir. Actually, we were talking about if on that day he has gone on that in that way, we would have talked in a way that even Duryodhana helped him a lot. Karna has left him. We have talked in that way. We are talking today because he has done that. He has supported him.
No, we are thinking about it deeply. What could have been an alternative way of acting?
They asked one question, no, sir. Who will you help the friend who was there in the exam, who is asking for your help? But I will tell him that I will teach him everything and whatever needed for the exam. But I will not help him in the exam. I will abide the rules of the teacher as well as the...
Wonderful. Like that you tell in Karna's case. How we can do that?
Sir,
how we can apply the same for Karna? Yeah.
I'll tell the Duryodhana that I will not fight along with you, but I will remain neutral as Krishna.
Neutral is what? Tirthyatra only. Just to go?
No. I will teach the other Kshatriyas to fight against the Pandavas. But he will not fight.
Oh, I will inspire others to fight. He won't fight. But Duryodhana will say, no, hey, I have done so much for you all these years. Fight for me, he will say. What he should say. So this is a very challenging dilemma. Is it not true? Anybody else has an answer? what you will do alternatively, you have a, you can give you can become advisor of Karna. Yeah, please. Then we can send you back in the ages 5,000 years ago.
So, Prabhu, I have a question. So, Prabhu, we are discussing that Karna was wrong. But isn't Indra on Arjuna's side? He was on Arjuna's side. Wasn't he wrong taking the kavacha from him? And Karna was knowing that Indra was coming in form of a Brahmin and he will take the kavacha after his puja.
Still he gave.
Still he gave. So, wasn't he, wasn't Indra wrong? Wasn't Arjuna wrong calling Karna a Shudra? Knowing that in Vedas, Shudra's caste system is not based on the birth. It is based on what karma you do. So Karna was doing Kshatriya's job. So wasn't Arjuna right calling Karna a Shudra and humiliating him in front of all those people?
Good question. See, Karna was such a great Danavir in giving. Being a Danavir also is a very noble quality on a material platform. Like friendship is a noble quality on a material platform. Friendship, keeping one's duty, keeping one's word, and also being a Danavir, giving, that's also a very wonderful quality. But everybody thought he is son of a Suta. Suta means a charioteer. Generally, in the Vedic times, if you are born in a Brahmana's family, you are assumed as a Brahmana in those days, because the father will teach the son all the Brahma Karma. He will do Brahma Karma, and they generally have the Brahminical qualities. Like you see, a doctor's son also becomes doctor oftentimes. A lawyer's son becomes a lawyer, generally speaking. But it is not necessary that a doctor's son will become a doctor. Similarly, because he was son of, he didn't call him as a Shudra. He called him Sutaputra. Sutaputra means you are son of a charioteer. Like that he called him. And this, the one Dadi, one, that was Kripacharya in the drama you saw. He was separating because he thought these are two lions. Arjuna and Karna are so powerful. If I don't stop the fight, they will kill each other. So he wanted to stop them. So he told him that the fights were fought only between royals. Arjuna belongs to royal family and you don't belong to royal family. So you cannot fight. So he wanted to separate the two great heroes. That's why he did like that. Calling him that you are born in a Sutaputra, so you cannot fight now. But everybody knew. People cheered and applauded for Karna as much as they applauded for Arjuna. Because nobody can hide talents. He had Kshatriya talents. And that is why when Karna was revealed, he is one of the Pandavas. He is the sixth Pandava. Then Karna understood, my five brothers are on that side. So what could alternatively be done? All of you consider this one last point which you are going to make now. All of you think about it. You see, Karna had all good qualities on a material platform. Friendship, keeping one's duty, gratitude, helpful, and gratitude for the food that somebody has given, which are all important. So there is a duty on a material platform, there is duty on the spiritual platform. So our duty on material platform is considered horizontal. Duty on the spiritual platform is considered vertical. And the duty on the material platform is for whom? For mother and father, for family and friends, for the nation, and for anybody to whom you are connected to in this world. Materially connected. You have many material relationships. And vertical duty is towards Krishna. That is spiritual duty. So out of the two, Shastra say both are important. We have to balance between material duties and spiritual duties. But when there is a tug of war between the two, which one should we accept? Spiritual duty or material duty? Why spiritual duty? Who can say? Because who are you? Are you material body or are you spirit soul? Out of the two, which is permanent?
Spiritual.
Spiritual. And that is what Vibhishan considered. Vibhishan thought, I am spirit soul, covered by material body, and my spirit soul relationship is with Ram. And my material body relationship is with Ravana, which is temporary. It will be finished at the time of death. So should I follow Ram or Ravan? So he gave a lot of sadupadesh to Ravana, but Ravana did not hear. Finally, he told him, Vinash Kale, Viparita Buddhi. So brother, I cannot follow you. So he went to join. It's not that Ram immediately accepted him. When Vibhishan went with four more Rakshasas flying in the sky, even other monkeys saw and they told Ram, he's a dangerous fellow. He's a spy in our army. So many monkeys told, Sugriva and all told, kill him on the spot. Don't accept him. Then Lord Ram heard all the monkeys. Even Angada said, my dear Lord Ram, you can accept him, but put a spy with him. wherever he goes, somebody should watch what is he doing and all that. But Hanuman was the only one who gave a recommendation. Hanuman said, when I came to Lanka, the whole of Lanka was filled with Rakshasas and Rakshasis, but there was one good soul who was chanting in his own palace, Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, like that. So I peeped through the window and I saw it was Vibhishan. I could not believe this. Is there a Rama Bhakta even in Lanka also? He was amazed. So he was very confident. And then all the monkeys said, we all have spoken so much. My dear Lord, now what is your opinion? They asked Ram. And Ram quoted a beautiful verse. He said, Sakridapi prapannoyam tavasmi iti yachate. Like that he says, Sakridapi prapannoyam, somebody comes and surrenders to me, I will never discard him. I will surely accept him. If somebody accepts me. And he said, Vibhishan has come to me, how will I reject him? I cannot reject him. And even if Ravana comes now, I will accept him, Lord Ram said. I will give back the Lanka to Ravana and say, I will take back Sita and you live happily here. And I will bless him and I will allow him to be Lanka Naresh. Like that he said, Lord Ram said. Hearing this, all the monkeys cried that Lord Ram is so compassionate and merciful. So, and that is why you find Vibhishan taking shelter of Ram. And apparently, materially, he is going against his brother. But spiritually, he is right on a spiritual platform. So, Shastras also say, the vertical duty is eternal. Your connection is eternal. And the material duty is mundane. In this general, you have somebody as a brother, sister, mother, father. In the next life, you will have new mother, father, brother, sister, everybody. So, only for a spiritual duty, one may sometimes compromise on material duty. So now what should Karna do now? He also understands Krishna is God. I am a soul. And I have eternal relation with him in the spiritual world. But my relation with Duryodhana is temporary. So what he should tell Krishna? He should tell Krishna that Krishna will exactly obey what you said. Because Karishye Vachanam Tava. Arjuna said, no? Like that, Krishna, whatever you say is good for everyone, the whole world. I will accept as you say. And for your sake, I am ready to earn a bad name from Duryodhana and the whole world. Because if Karna said to Krishna, I will join the Pandava side, but the war should be stopped. And the war will be stopped. You know what? If Karna joined Pandava side, Duryodhana would have never fought the battle. Because he was very much banking on Karna. He respected Karna more than Vibhishan also. I mean, more than Vishwamitrama also. But Karna had told Duryodhana, as long as Bhishma doesn't get out of the battle, I will not go in. You know that? He had taken a vow also. So he should tell Krishna that I am coming. I will be joining your side. But if you assure that there will be no war, Pandavas will be sharing the kingdom with Duryodhana. They should be given some part of the kingdom. And Duryodhana will get some part of the kingdom and the war should be stopped. And Krishna agrees. Because Krishna came for Shanti Dut. Correct, no? Why will he want the war? And then he should go to Duryodhana's side. And tell Duryodhana, hey Duryodhana, please remember, I am not joining Pandavas because I have come to know that they are my brothers. I am not joining for that. If I would do that, I would be a mean-minded person. Correct, no? Just because these five people are my brothers, so I will join and they say, tata to you and go away. You know? It's not proper. I am not joining. But Krishna himself has invited me to be on the Pandava side. And he is a supreme God. To obey him. I cannot go back. And I am very sorry, I cannot fight for you. I would have surely fought for you from a material point of view, but from a spiritual point of view, God is calling me. When God's call comes, everything else. Imagine, Jugnu can be shining in the night, but when sun shines in the sky, Jugnu has no place. Similarly, you are like a Jugnu, Duryodhana. Krishna is like a sun. When Krishna is calling me, I have to salute him and obey him. I am going to go on. I will complete my statement. I have to obey Krishna. And then as a friend, Duryodhana, I am telling you, see, we jointly, we drove the Pandavas to the jungle 12 years. And incognito period also they completed. 1 year Ajnatavas also. We disrobed their wife in public and Krishna protected the man of Draupadi also. And Pandava children, ideally speaking, out of the three, Pandu, Dhritarashtra and Vidura, who was the king? Anybody knows? Pandu was the king, not Dhritarashtra, because Dhritarashtra was blind. And Vidura could not be the king because Vidura was born from a Dasi. He was not accepting the kingship. So only Pandu was king. So if Pandu was king, who is supposed to rule the whole world? So Karna should tell Duryodhana, see, Pandu's descendants are Pandavas. But they are ready to take 5 villages and be happy. Huh? Can't you give you 5 villages? Why are you so unreasonable? Huh? If you claim to be my friend, I tell you, just give them 5 villages or divide the world into half the property, half Kauravas will rule, half you rule. And that is a very reasonable proposal for which Krishna came as a Shanti Dut. Do you want to see crores of people dying in the battlefield, Duryodhana? So it's not proper. So in any case, I am going to live with the Pandavas on the order of Krishna. And you can also rule the world. They can rule the world. We will share the kingdom. If you do this, you will be glorious. And if you don't do this, I will be with Pandava, with Krishna. The war will be inevitable and you fight. Then I will be obeying Krishna's order. If Karna said it, there is a great possibility that the war would have stopped. Now you can ask the question.
Even the Pandavas could have told, I don't want those 5 villages. I don't want material benefits. I just want to...
No, mic. Mic, you can keep the mic. Yeah?
So the Pandavas could have said that I don't want those 5 villages. I don't want material benefits. I will come with Krishna. I will come to spiritual world. They could have said that. And the war could have been evaded.
Oh, they already said it. When they returned from the forest after 13 years, Yusuf Maharaj came and saw Hastinapur. People were all apparently very happy. There was so much material affluence because Duryodhana had, because elections are going to come now, he had pampered the people like anything. If somebody deserved 1,000 rupees salary, he gave them 20,000 salary. Like that, he was pampering. Why he was pampering the praja? He knew Pandavas are going to return now and they will demand the kingdom back. I have to keep my praja so happy. And like some politicians say, no, vote for me, I will open a liquor shop in the middle of your village and I will open a new cinema theater. Like that, Duryodhana also did campaigning. Whatever people wanted, he was providing that. So when Yudhishthira Maharaj saw that, he told Krishna, my dear Krishna, people seem to be very happy. So then why should we demand the kingdom back? Let us go back to jungle. And let him rule. Ideally speaking, you rule or I rule. Ultimately, people should be happy. That's what who said? Duryodhana, Yusuf Maharaj said that. But Bhima, Bhima and Draupadi, they were not happy about that. Plus Krishna also said that, you know, Krishna also wanted to see that these are a Dharma Parayan. They should take lead because in fact, Arjuna told in the beginning of battlefield of Kurukshetra, Krishna, if I kill all the warriors on Kaurava side, all their wives will become widows. And if they become widows, widows will be abused by other men in society. And the children born to widows will be Varna Sankara. Unwanted progeny, he said. Krishna said, no, Arjuna, you don't understand. If you fight this battle and kill all the Kaurava men, their wives will be widows. But they will be protected under the rule of Yudhishthira Maharaj. Yudhishthira Maharaj will become like the father of all these women. And he will ensure that no man can abuse them. Either Krishna said. Krishna argued. Krishna was very confident that Yudhishthira should be the leader and Pandava should be their followers and all of them are virtuous. And Duryodhana also can have some kingdom. But Duryodhana wanted to rule the whole world and wipe out the Pandavas. And that was his wrong desire. You understand, no? Yeah.
Prabhu? Karna was facing a tug of war between material and spiritual duty. What kind of duty is that where God is standing in front of you and your guru is standing in front of you and you'll go touch the feet of your guru first? What kind of duty is this where you will go first to your guru and then to the God?
Who is doing that?
Sir, it's said that Kubir said statement.
Arjuna sent, at the beginning of the battlefield, Arjuna sent 2 arrows which came and fell at the feet of Dronacharya.
Yes, so.
Then it came and fell at the feet of Bhishma. You know, then Duryodhana was wondering, what is this? Arjuna is aiming arrows in the ground. What kind of fool is he? Then the 2 acharyas told him, you fool. He is not throwing on the ground, he is offering namaskar to us. They said.
So, what kind of duty is this, material or spiritual?
Which one?
Going
against the guru. I tell you, you know the story of Vamanadev? When Lord Vamanadev came, like a small dwarf brahmana, to the arena of Bali Maharaj, the guru was Shukracharya. Shukracharya told Bali Chakravarti, who was a Rakshasa leader, but who had taken all the worlds. He had usurped from the devatas and he had taken all the worlds. And his guru told him, Shukracharya, hey Bali! This small Brahmana boy is Sakshat Vishnu. If you give him 3 steps of land, he will loot all your property. I don't know how. but he will loot all the property. So be very cautious. But Bali Chakravarti said, if you say this is Vishnu, then why can't I give him 3 steps? In fact, all the belongings I possess belong to Lord Vishnu only. So he went against his guru. And then he gave the Argya. And guru went into the command loo and became a Brahmar. You know, that, and he was blocking. He could not get any water. And then Vamandev saw it in his Jnana Shiksha and he smiled. He took his Dhruva grass and he poked it into that. And then the bumblebee got it in the eyes. And again it came out. Came out, eyes bleeding. Sukracharya came out. He was in the form of a Brahmar. Then he poured and then he gave it off. So when he gave it off, Lord grew into huge size. And he measured the upper works, lower works, everything. And then he told Bali Chakravarti, hey Bali, you told me you'll give me 3 steps. You now I have only taken 2. Where is the place for 3rd step? At that time, Bali said, my dear Lord, I have given whatever I had, but my head is still there. So you can put your 3rd foot on my head. And Lord put the 3rd foot on his head. And because Bali surrendered like this, Lord Vishnu gave him blessing. He said, now I will send you to a place called Suttala Loka, which is better than Swarga also. You become Raja there. And I will become your Dwarpalak. You know, Lord became his Dwarpal there. Lord Vamanadev. And then after you complete your term, you will become the next Indra also. Lord gave him blessing. So he became blessed because Bali surrendered to Lord. Similarly, Vibhishan also surrendered to Lord. On the other hand, you find when Lord Narsingadev appeared from the pillar. At that time, Hiranyakashipu was wondering, what is this cracking noise? The huge pillar is cracking. Till then, Hiranyakashipu was an unrivaled king. Nobody could. He was so powerful. And then we're getting late now. 5 minutes, I'll finish. You see, Hiranyakashipu was so powerful. When the sun was hot, she would twist his eyebrows. Hey! He would say. He would twist the eyebrows. And immediately the sun would control his temperature. Can you imagine? Someday evening, you will go to the park. And you look at the sky and say, Halka Barish, he would say. And immediately there will be a drizzling from the sky. Such a control you had over nature. Is there anybody nowadays like that? If we are finding the sun hot, we make our room air-conditioned room. That's all we can do. You can't control the sun. But this fellow suddenly found when the pillar broke open and Narsingadev came making a roaring sound. He was wondering, what is this creature? Half man, half man. He couldn't understand. Was wondering. And then he found that all the rules are being fulfilled. The Lord is neither an animal nor a human being. And he saw the clock. It is neither day nor night. He came in the Sandhyakal. And also Lord came out and he picked up Hiranyakashipu. And Lord was taking, he was waving hands and legs. Hey, where is he taking me? And the Lord went to the door entrance. And he understood neither inside the palace nor outside the palace. That one last chance Hiranyakashipu had. He could have told the Lord, my dear Lord, wait a minute. Now today onwards, I will become a Vaishnava devotee. I am surrendered to your lotus feet now. Then Lord would have got confused whether to break his belly or not. Correct, no? Because one becomes a devotee, Lord will not kill that person. Why should he kill him? He may immediately, Hiranyakashipu, in case he offered obeisances to Lord Narsingha, surrender to him. Now the whole scene would have changed. Lord Narsingadev would be sitting and Hiranyakashipu would garland him and father and son would do Namaste Narasimha. Correct, no? So the history would have changed. Correct, no? But he did not surrender. So he was broken open. Correct, no? So in the Shastra, you find some people surrender and they are saved. And some people don't surrender and they perish. So Duryodhana is in which category? He was an unreasonable fellow. He said, I won't give land even which could be contained in the tip of a needle, he said. So because of his unreasonable nature and because of his desire to wipe out the Pandava, who were great devotees of Krishna, he was bearing malice in his heart for the Pandavas, because of which he was destroyed. And Karna was in between. You see, this is Karna's situation. See, material sentimental attachment or friendship that Karna felt very strongly. Material attachment he felt for Duryodhana. On one side, there was Krishna, the Supreme Lord. There was Dharma. Pandavas were there and they were also dharmic people. And all the Pandavas are brothers. Mother Kunti was calling. All these things are pulling him. On the other side, we had Duryodhana's favor. He made him Angadeshka Raja, so he saved his ego and the public, saved his face, and there was thick friendship of Karna, Duryodhana also. And the promise is given. He has given promise to Duryodhana, I'll fight for your side. He gave food and maintenance. So these are the points his devotees made. So they're a brilliant presentation. Actually, well, there was one last question for which you have no time. In your life also, all of you, many of you sitting here, you are becoming devotees. But you will have some friends with whom you have a very thick relationship. But if those friends happen to be like Duryodhana, it's very dangerous for you. Because you want them to come to Krishna's side. Karna is basically telling Duryodhana, I am going to Krishna's side, you also come. Basically, we all will obey Krishna. Like that, Karna can say. And the whole problem will be solved. Similarly, all of you can bring your friends also to Krishna consciousness. But if your friends say, no, we don't want to come, they will want you to come to Maya's side. Hey, kya yaar, ye sab chhod do yaar, baad mein dekha jayega. Budde hone ke baad dekhenge. Some people say like that, no? Abhi kya isko pakad kar rakha, like that there are people who pull you. So you also have a tug of war in your heart. You have your old materialistic friends, and you have, if you come to devotees, they will say, please increase your rounds. Please chant Hare Krishna. Please lead a pure life. Your facilitators are your well-wishers, your seniors, correct? How much time and energy they are putting on you in bringing you closer to Krishna. They have only one desire, to see you become pure and you go back to Godhead. They have a selfless desire to help you. They want you to come to Krishna's side. And your other friends are telling, no, you come to our side. You have our friendship. You know, we both know each other very well. So you come. So you all will face tug of war also. So let us see how many of you will survive taking Krishna's side. And how many of you will be pulled by Duryodhana's side. Dekha jayega abhi. No, they are advising. Vidura advice, Bhishma advice, Drona advice. That is not as important for Duryodhana as when Karna is advising. Because Karna was a very thick friend and you depended on him. Duryodhana would consider Karna his enemy now, but he will understand that now his side becomes very weak. No, see, but Karna, by going to Pandava's side, he is weakening Duryodhana more to come to the right path. Correct? No, see, he is making, for example, say one of your friends is asking you that, you know, can you please give me this notebook, you know, which you have made, such a nice notes you have made. You tell him, please come to my room, we will chat one round of Hare Krishna together. And I'll give you the notebook. For your sake, he will chant. Correct, no? And then you give him the notebook. So he knows that whenever he asks this fellow anything, he will ask for one round chanting.
No, Prabhu, Duryodhana.
That way, Karna is forcibly bringing him to the right path.
No, what my argument is, Duryodhana would never come to the right path. He was that so.
Nobody can say. Because even God doesn't control our future. You know that? Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, he knows the consequences of our choices. But your future is in your hands only. Because God, Lord is so great that he never interferes with the choice of the jiva. Your choice is that you can go back to God in this very life or you can go back after a million lives. Krishna doesn't interfere. And Duryodhana can change his mind seeing that are sab log and everybody has changed. Now I am left all alone. There is a likelihood of changing. Especially on Karna, he depended very much. If he doesn't change, then Karna could have took a stand similar to Vibhishan. That's what would have been ideal. Because it's a spiritual side. It's a dharma which is not ordinary dharma. It's a dharma given by God himself and God is inviting, that's the highest side. Still, I would like to appreciate this team of devotees also, because both the teams of devotees have deeply contemplated, introspected and thought about this episode, and they brought out such valuable points, put them on the table in front of all of us, and it's not an ordinary thing. And that too, to sit in front of so many big audience and speak out the points, not an easy thing. So we would like to give all of them special prasad. Actually, this kind of tug of war competition to perform, it requires extensive use of one's intelligence thinking. You understand? So this is called transcendental morality. You understand? So thank you very much. Yeah. Why Bhishma is on Kaurava's side? There is a great secret behind it. Prabhupada explains it. In the spiritual world, Lord has 5 rasas, which we will discuss in the next camp. But one, our rasa outside 5 rasas is called Virya Ras, where Lord likes to have stunt with his devotee. How many of you like stunt scenes in movies? Correct, no? So Lord also likes stunt. That's why you are also liking. You understand? No? Because we are part and parcel. So, but in spiritual world, nobody will do stunt with him. When Lord says, fight with me, somebody can take a lotus flower and throw it on the Lord, you know? Because they cannot fight with him. God sometimes creates this kind of situation to teach we people, because we have both sides in our heart, no? We have bad side, good side. So we should learn to behave more like the Pandavas and not like Kauravas. That's what we learn. But from eternal point of view, none of them are having any such impurity. That will be the last question, then we are having an announcement.
Prabhuji, Krishna is a God. So he knows the past, future and present.
No, he doesn't know the future. He only knows the consequences of his future. I'll tell you an example. How many of you know the Brahmin and Kapila story? You know the Brahmin and Kapila story? Anyway, Narada met one Brahmin who was very proud of his yajna and disciples and everything. Then he met one Kapila who was very humble, simple and everything. So later on, Narada went to spiritual world and met Lord Narayana. And he asked, my dear Lord, both that Brahmana and Kapila asked me, when will they come back to Godhead? You know, spiritual world. So Lord Narayana said, cobbler will come back to me in this very life. Whereas Brahmana will come back to me after a million lives, he said. And then he was wondering, why is it so? Because Brahmana is doing so much yajna, dan and everything. He is very learned in Sanskrit shlokas and all that. So when he again came back, Lord Narayana said, you go and tell them that when you came to Vaikuntha, I was putting elephant into the eye of a needle hole. So then Narada came down. So Brahmana was performing yajna and he asked her. So Narada, did you go to Vaikuntha? What did Lord Narayana say about me? When will I come back to Godhead? So he said, I'm very sorry to say, Brahmana, you will take a million lives. Lord said, and Brahmana became very angry. I think you have never gone to Vaikuntha. You are telling me lies. And then he said, if you really went to Vaikuntha, tell me, what was Lord doing there? And then Narada said, Lord was putting an elephant into the eye hole of a needle. Then Brahmana laughed and said, what is this nonsense? You are joking. Can anybody put such a big elephant into the eye hole of a needle? I think you are telling stories. I don't want to trust you anymore. Get lost from here, Brahmana said. Then Narada went away from there. He went to the cobbler. And cobbler immediately did namaskar to Narada and he got up. And he said, Narada, sages like you come and sanctify my home. And then he said, please. So please tell me, when will I go back to Godhead? More lifetimes are pending for me, he asked. And Narada said, in this very life, you'll go back to Godhead. He told him. And then he asked, did you meet Lord Narayana? What did he say? What was he doing? Then he said, he was putting an elephant into the eye hole of a needle. And then this cobbler started dancing, saying, how wonderful is my Lord, how wonderful he is. What is there in this world that he cannot do, he said. Narada asked him, do you really believe somebody can put an elephant into a hole of a needle? So the cobbler said, somebody cannot do it, but Lord can do it, he said. Why? He said, look at this banyan tree I'm sitting under. This has got so many millions of seeds, it's dropping down. One seed can produce such a huge banyan tree like this. If Lord can put such a big tree in a small seed like this, why can't he put elephant into a needle hole? Like that he asked. And hearing this, Narada said, what a faith this person has. Because the Sanskrit shlokas, they say, kartum akartum sarvata kartum. God can do what you can do, what God can do, what you cannot do, and God can do beyond both also. Anything he can do. There is nothing that he cannot do. So, that type of faith is required. Imagine if the Brahmana changed his attitude and became like the cobbler, in this very life, he will also go back to God. Not that he will take million lives. You understand, no? When Lord Vishnu said, Narada, that he may take millions of lives, that means his attitude is such that it appears to me that he is going to take millions of lives. He has a very improper attitude. He has no faith. But if you develop faith, in this very life, he will come back to me. So, God is not controlling our future. You understand, no?
Yes.
So, like, for example, you are studying in a class now. You can be a 9-pointer or you can be a 6-pointer based on how you study. Teacher may predict about you. For example, if you are getting 9, she may say, he's a good boy. I think, you know, he is going to get a gold medal. Somebody else, maybe the teacher may say, oh, I think mostly he may settle with 6 to 7 points by the time he passes out. That's based on the teacher's estimation about the record, past record. But a boy can completely change his track record by, you know, studying more and changing his method of study. Correct, no? I had one boy in Pune, 52% he was having when he came to Krishna consciousness. When he started chanting more rounds, next year he got 72. Even his parents couldn't believe. The parents said, we want to see your Guruji. Who is it? How did you get 72 marks now? So the parents came and they saw our center and everything. So how he changed? Because after he became a devotee, he became very serious in studies. Till then he was wasting his time in so many activities. You understand, no? So God doesn't control our future. It's in our hands only. Okay? Thank you very much.
Where is it? Okay, I'll answer. Where is it starting?
Question.
Now we will ask questions.
That is all, you can ask.
Hare Krishna? Yeah, it's done. Now I'll go. Hare Krishna. Okay. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. That's coming now here. Hare Krishna. Okay. So now, after hearing about the tug of war, if you all have any questions on the subject, please kindly put your questions. I'll answer them now. So Sugriva Prabhu is saying, Hare Krishna Prabhuji, thank you so much. Thank you. Srinivas is also saying, Hare Krishna Prabhuji. Rashmi Prabha Mataji saying, Hare Krishna. All Kaushal Kumar is saying, Hare Krishna. Anybody has any questions? So today, what we discussed was a very important topic of tug of war. Because in our lives also, we all face tug of war. One side, the devotees are pulling us, chant more rounds, come to Krishna, go back to Godhead, and lead a pure life. And on the other hand, our other karmis or non-devotees, they are pulling us in other side. So here is a question by Durga Prasad Dangi Prabhu. Dangi is asking, Prabhuji, how to take advices of our college friends? So in case your college friend gives you an advice, I would suggest that you should check it with Shastra. Is that advice anukul or pratikul for you? Anukul means it's favorable for your Krishna consciousness. Pratikul means it's unfavorable. So, we have to be very careful about accepting. You may have a friend like Karna had Duryodhana as a friend, which was dangerous for him. On the other hand, you may have a good friend also. So you have to be watchful about, is it going to help me in my Krishna consciousness or not? Somebody says, chalo, we are going out, but where? You want to go? You want to go to your temple or you want to go to your cinema theater? Somebody says, chalo, let us eat now. You have to ask, what do you want me to eat? Do you want to eat meat or do you want to eat prasad? So, therefore, many of your friends will give you advice. Don't protest. Don't quarrel with them. Just nod the head. But heart of hearts, you should know that Shastras, Guru, Sadhu, Shastra, whatever they are teaching, that's what I should follow in my life. So here Durga Prasad is explaining further. Like they will better tell about career. Oh yes, that is all right. You can talk about career. If your friends are able to help you in getting a good job, or you want to go abroad, or you want to study for some competitive exam, we can discuss such things. You can certainly hear from them. And you have to, one thing we are talking about now today is, if they are taking you away from Krishna, you should not allow that. You know the story of monkey and the crocodile. The crocodile took the monkey for a joyride in the lake, but then he was planning to take the monkey to his wife to cook his heart. When he told him, the monkey became shocked. And he told that, my dear crocodile, I have kept my heart in the I have kept my heart in the tree. Please go back. Let me pick it up. So once he came to tree, he told the crocodile, get lost. Henceforth, I will never trust you because you are trying to kill me. Similarly, some of our friends may take us to hell. We should not allow them. But if they are talking about career, talking about studies, talking something beneficial for you, it's all right. And Gulshan Sharma Prabhu is asking, thank you for your classes. Saying, okay, Gulshan, thank you. Durga Prasad Prabhu is asking, how to consider it in terms of our spiritual practices? I just now told you, if it is affecting your spiritual life, you have to keep a distance. You should neglect it. There are many things friends may tell you, why don't you do this, why don't you do that? If it is not good for us, hey, it has gone. Therefore, I told you two words in Sanskrit. Anukul, pratikul. Anukul means favorable to your spiritual life. Pratikul means, you know, detrimental to your spiritual life. So that's the basis on which we should see it. Anjana Mataji is asking a question. Prabhuji, what is your advice for college students regarding their career and academics? Oh, we can surely have friends to discuss about our academics and studies. And we can also have friends with whom we discuss about our future career. I don't see any problem in this. But we should avoid friends who spoil you with bad habits like smoking, drinking, while watching adult movies. And some other friends may talk dirty things. So we have to avoid those friends who are impure in their habits and behavior so that we don't contaminate the same things because it is contagious, you see. And Kaushal Kumar Prabhuji is asking, more I want to come to Krishna consciousness, more I feel like getting dragged against it with even more power. How to come out of it with more determination? Good question. You see, right now we are in material world. So the material, push and pull are acting on us. So I would suggest to Kaushal Prabhu that regularly read Prabhupada's books. And rise early in the morning and chant the holy name. And also keep yourself surrounded by good devotee association. So ABCD formula, association of devotees, studying the books regularly, chanting early in the morning, as I told you, eat prasadam, offer it to Krishna and take it, live a pure life, keep away from bad association. So eventually your strength will increase. I'll tell you one example for Kaushal Kumar's beautiful question. You all know that once all the Pandavas were in one village, and in that village one Bakasura used to come and eat the people. So the village people made an agreement that every day they will send one person with a bullock cart full of food. So when Pandava saw the situation, all the villagers were in great fear. So he told that family, today your turn is there. You have to go to feed him the bullock cart. Bhima said, I will take it. So Bhima took that bullock cart of food and he went to the forest. And that big demon came, Bakasura came. So when he came, what do you think Bhima did? You know, even before the demon came, Bhima started eating from the cart. And the demon became angry. Hey, instead of giving me, you are eating it. But then Bhima, by eating, he was getting strength. And he gave a punch on the chest of the demon. And the demon fell far away. By the time the demon would get up and come, Bhima would eat more. So with one hand, he was eating. With the other hand, he was giving him punch. Like that. So, Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Tani sarvani samyamya yukta asita matparaha. He says, you know, take to more and more Krishna consciousness through chanting, reading, hearing, association. That will give you strength and stamina. And also keep temptations far away. Keep bad association far away. So, Tani sarvani samyamya yukta asita matparaha. He says, So, this is my answer for Kushal Kumar Prabhu's question. You will definitely not be dragged. You will get better when you come to Sattvaguna. Now, the Tamaguna, Rajaguna is dragging us. But eventually, the more you take Krishna conscious nourishment, you will get the strength. And you will get the strength to say no to bad things and yes to good things. Like, you know, when some bad sound comes, some dirty song is coming, it's going to go in your ears will say no. So, yes to Krishna, no to Maya. Similarly, eyes also. Yes to Krishna, no to Maya. You will take darshan of Krishna, but you won't see dirty things. You won't eat dirty things. And Gulshan Prabhu is asking, you told in class, sometimes difficult to balance sadhana, job and preaching. Yeah, there is some difficulty in that. But the more we come to Sattvaguna, you'll be able to do that very easily. Because in Tamaguna, we are helplessly dragged. In Rajoguna, we make a principle, we follow it for some time, then we give it up. Again, we follow some time, we give it up. Whereas in Sattvaguna, you can be very steady. It's possible to be steady. So I would suggest that rise early in the morning, chant the holy names, and also morning is Sattvaguna, and eat sattvic prasad offered to Krishna. So in this way, Sattvaguna will help us to become steady. Nikhil Patil Prabhu is asking, how to develop taste for Prabhupada books? Answer is very simple, by reading. The proof of the pudding is in its eating. So in case you find it difficult to develop taste on your own, sit with a group of devotees and you all read and discuss together. Every one of you can add a few points of what you understand. It will become interesting. If Nikhil Prabhu sends me a mail, I can reply you back with the list of Prabhupada books and how to read Prabhupada books. You can send a mail to me, radhesham.rns@iskonpune.in. Okay. And Gulshan is again asking question. Which sloka, Prabhu, this Tani Yani Samyam Bhagavataya? Sloka, it's in second chapter. Tani Sarvani Samyamya Yukta Asita Mat Paraha Vashehi Asyendriyani Tasya Prajna Pratishtitha. That's the second chapter. You will find it. After the Siddha Prajna section in 60 plus verses, you will find in that. And Anjana Mataji is asking a question. As we come to Krishna consciousness, we get more taste in it. And we find less taste in material subjects. And we feel less interested in academics. So how to deal with it? I have observed this. You see, Arjuna had two roles. One was he's a warrior. And another role is a Krishna's devotee. So Krishna told him, yes, you are my wonderful devotee, but you should do two things. Tasmat sarveshu kaleshu mamanusmara yudhyacha mayyar pitamano buddhir mame vashyasya samshayah. He told mamanusmara yudhyacha. Remembering me, you should fight the battle. Similarly, Anjana Mataji, you are a student. So remembering Krishna, you should do your studies. You should combine both. So one easy way, I'll tell you how. In Karma Yoga, four questions can be answered. Who are you? The answer is, I am God's servant, Krishna's servant. What do? I do work, which is God's work. How do you do the work? I do it responsibly, in a committed way, sincerely, seriously, with dedication. And what do you do with the results? I offer all my results to God. So this is the consciousness of a karma yogi. So Hanuman, for example, he did God's work. He did it very diligently. He endeavored hard to find Sita. And he offered all the fruits to Lord Rama. He said, it's all by your mercy I could do this. So in this way, you do your academics as an offering to Krishna. How to do that? When you get good marks, tell your friends that it's all because I am chanting Hare Krishna. I got concentration. I could cleanse my mind. I became free from tension. So all of you also, please take to chanting. Then in this way, your good marks and academics can be utilized for preaching Krishna consciousness. And Rashmi Prabha Mataji is asking a question. Krishna and Krishna's name are non-different. How to develop such feelings while chanting as Krishna's name as powerful as Krishna himself? How to hold this with firm conviction? See, why it is mentioned that Krishna and his name are non-different. In this world, somebody may be called as a Sundar Kanaya, but he may not be beautiful. Somebody may be called as a Lakshmipati, but he may be a beggar in this world. Somebody may be called as a Padma Lochan, but he may be a blind man. The name doesn't correspond to his qualities or characteristics. And also in this world, you find people sometimes are beautiful, but their character is not good. Some people are good character, but their beauty is not there. Somebody is, looking externally not so good looking, but very intelligent boy. Somebody is very handsome looking, but he's a muff. He has no intelligence. So therefore, material world, the name and form are not matching. In Krishna's case, when you say Krishna, all attractive, he is beautiful, all rich, all knowledgeable, all strong, all famous, and all renounced. So when you are chanting the holy name, you can know that I am addressing Radha and Krishna, and they are the personification of all beauty, all strength, all knowledge. Everything is perfectly all in one. They have. Therefore, in movies, you find they put a beautiful cinema actor or actress, and they also portray them as a very good person. And also they do a dubbing voice of somebody else to, like Lata Mangeshkar, to sing behind. So they're merging, beauty and all other qualities in one person in order to make that person look, which is all farce, which is cheating. But in the real sense, in Lord Krishna, his name and all the characteristics are same. I would say that if you are reading Krishna book, as well as Srimad Bhagavatam, and it's only a matter of time. Gradually, our appreciation of Radha and Krishna will increase eventually. And then when we are chanting the holy name, we know that they are my Swami and Swamini. And I am chanting for their pleasure. They are my ultimate, global mother and father. And the conviction will gradually build. When we read about the lives of devotees like Dhruva, or Prahalad, or Ambarish, or Gajendra. Okay. Radha Govind Prabhu is saying Hare Krishna. Okay, thank you, Hare Krishna. And Kalyan Kali is Prabhu is saying that third question in quiz, in your words, choice wrong or right. Which is third question in the quiz? I don't know which quiz is it. Oh, correct. I asked four questions. What was the third question? I will tell you about the answer to that very soon. So I had given five questions. Okay, let me see the third question. Okay. What do you feel about the choice made? Was it right or wrong? If right, what would you like to appreciate? If wrong, how could he have acted alternatively? Okay, the answer to this question is Karna's decision was wrong. He should not have joined Duryodhana, because along with Duryodhana, he also got destroyed. So if it is wrong, how could he have acted alternatively? I will tell you what I would have done. If I was in that role of Karna, I would tell Krishna that, yes, Krishna, I will join you very soon. Just give me a week time. Then I will go to Duryodhana and say, my dear friend, you see, the Pandavas' request for 5 villages is not a very big demand. You should have some common sense. They are very powerful people like lions. Better you give them the 5 villages. And if you won't give, you know, and you won't give even a land in the tip of a needle, then I am very sorry to say, because you are following the path of Adharma, and Lord Krishna is the father of all Dharma. Lord Krishna is like the sun. And all other Dharma of this world is like a candle in front of Krishna. So I have decided to join the side of Pandavas, because I also want to walk the path of Dharma. I never liked even the gambling match after which they were driven away to forest in a mean-minded way without chivalrously fighting. So like that you can say. And then you can say that, see, if I join, then what will happen? I'll tell you. If Karna joins the side with Pandavas, then Karna, Yudhishthira and all the other Pandavas come to one side, then Duryodhana will become afraid. Then he will oblige. Then he will go for agreement with Duryodhana. I mean, Duryodhana will go for agreement with Yudhishthira and say that, okay, Chalo, Yudhishthira, you become the king and you allot part of the world to me and my brothers. Then there will be no more war. If Karna had joined, very likely that there would not have been a war. That's my answer to Kalyan. And because ultimately, Lord's God's word is the ultimate word, because you know, he is a supreme well-wisher of all of us. So I would have followed that one. Okay, now Naveen Sagam Prabhu is saying, Pam, okay. Yeah, Naveen Sagam Prabhu is asking a question. Do people work in night shifts come under Aryan category? Actually, Aryan are the people who are Vedic followers, ideally speaking. We should rise early in the morning and do our spiritual duties and everything and do the work in the daytime and sleep with the sun and wake up with the sun. That's ideal. But unfortunately, nowadays, there are 3 shifts in which companies are calling people. So I would only tell Naveen Sagam Prabhu that even if you have to work in shift for a while, you can request the company that, you know, please give me a regular day job, because changing these 3 shifts, you know, throws off the biological clock. It's very hurting to both body, the physical body, producing many diseases, as well as not good for spiritual life also. Yeah. So Lavanya Mataji is asking a question. How to do concentrated chanting? Few rounds could do concentrated, but not all 16 rounds. Okay. I have an article called, 2 articles I can send you. One is called Art of Concentration. It's a part of His Holiness Mahanidhi Swami's chanting book. I have cut and pasted that. I have with me. I can send you Art of Increasing Concentration. Another article I can send you is Art of Keeping the Mind Aloof from Wandering During Chanting. So which is actually a lecture transcript. I can send you both. If you send me a mail, radhesham.rns@iskonpune.in. Okay. So Kalyan is satisfied, it seems. He's saying, thank you, Prabhuji. Thank you, Kalyan. Yeah. Now, are the questions over now? Thank you for all of your questions. And I'm sure you would have enjoyed the tug of war. So there was material attachment in the heart of, Karna. So Karna's, there were less noble and more noble motivations, which actually kept him in touch with Duryodhana. So the goal of this discussion today is mainly this, that in this world, we have 2 natures, higher nature and lower nature. If we side with lower nature, like Karna sided with Duryodhana, then we degrade. Our consciousness becomes hellish. And if you are siding with Krishna's devotees and Krishna's invitation, then we are uplifting our consciousness. Then the Daivi Sampath, divine assets, will come in our lives. So all of you devotees, you are already on the right path. Just like Arjuna was told by Krishna that, my dear Arjun, you Daivi Sampat Vimokshaya Nibandaya Asuri Mata. He said, my dear Arjuna, although there is Daivi Sampat, Asuri Sampat, you are born of divine Sampat, he said. So I can say the same thing to all of you. You are all born of divine assets because you are so sincere in chanting and hearing these lectures and studying Bhagavad Gita and trying to become a better and better devotee. And you have to stay connected, stay sincere, stay pure, and not be misled by the wrong propaganda of the materialistic people. So therefore, one should avoid their bad association and stay in good association. Make a circle of devotees around you and stay in their company and stay safe and stay secure and win the tug of war. Winning the tug of war means, you know, between the tug of war between Krishna and Maya, you go with Krishna. Then your life becomes all perfect. So thank you. Now can we do kirtan? Where is the kartan? Yes. Okay, can play kartan? So yeah. So we'll do 5 minutes kirtan. Conclude the session today. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Ram Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram 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 Hare Hare Jaya Prabhupada Jaya Prabhupada Prabhupada Srila Prabhupada Haribol, 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 Nittai Gaura Haribol. Kaliyuga Pavana Harinama Sankirtanaki, Ananta Koti Vaishnava Vrindaki. Thank you.